everyone, it's Emily, and today I'm building another small little house. I'm kind of back on my schedule, but not really. It's still a little bit all over the place, but it's a Sunday. Is it a Sunday? Yes, it's a Sunday, and I have a little small house for you on, you know, this classic 20 by 20 lot in Brindleton Bay that I absolutely can't get over building on. But today we're doing probably one of my last, like, super jungle adventure-y type of builds. This isn't as over the top as some of the other ones that I've been doing recently, like the ones that I've actually done in Salvadorada, but now this is kind of like still using a lot of stuff from the pack and pretty much like using everything that I can, like in the kitchen and the bedroom and all that stuff. Actually, I think I used a different bed. Yeah, I used one of the ones from City Living. But anyway, this is probably one of the last like super themed ones I'm going to be doing, at least for a while, because I'm kind of burning myself out on all of the jungle stuff. But I think that that's fine. I still do have a spa that I want to get done, because I feel like spa day and jungle adventure go really well together, with the idea of like going on vacation and having a spa there. So I want to do a build that's just spa day and jungle adventure, but that will be my probably like actually last like super jungle adventure-y build. Just so you guys know what my channel is going to be looking like. It's going to be back to normal soon, but I'm a little all over the place now because, first of all, new pack. Second of all, it's like midterm time for me in school, so yeah, my free time has just totally like gone down the drain, and I have a lot of like papers and tests and stuff to be studying for all at once. Not that I wasn't having papers and tests to do before, but they were like spread out a little bit. Like, my schedule was actually pretty nice, and none of my professors like overlapped stuff that was due, so I kind of had like one thing due every week, and that was pretty easy to manage. But now I have like three things due this week and like three tests next week, so I'm just trying to keep up with everything, and it's going pretty well. But yeah, my schedule has suffered a little bit, and because of that, just so you guys know, in case any of you, I mean, I know that a lot of people probably just watch my builds and not my other stuff, but I do like Not So Berry Challenge updates on Mondays, and those won't be happening for the next two Mondays, so we're taking a little 3-week break from that, because I really just haven't had time to play the game. Like, even making the time for like an hour every week to play my Upgrowth Challenge family has taken, I mean, that's like, I only play for an hour, so it's like easy to set boundaries of like, okay, I'm just gonna play for this hour, record this part for the week, and then I'm done. But to play my Not So Berry Challenge family is a little bit more than that. Like, I would usually play for like several hours every week to have actual progress to update you on, but yeah, I just haven't had time to play. So if any of you guys watching also watch that, I'll probably mention this in my video tomorrow, which will be a create a sim or like a townie makeover type of thing. I don't know, it's kind of a weird mix. You'll see when it comes out. But yeah, just wanted to throw that out there now so that it's not like the day that I post a create a sim instead of Not So Berry and people are like, what's going on? Even though I think for the most part, most people don't really pay that much attention to my schedule. I think I'm just kind of hyper aware of it, and I don't want to let anyone who may care down. I don't know, but I really like this house. I kind of made it a little bit more modern than some of the other stuff I've been doing, and I also finally started watching other people's videos of stuff with Jungle Adventure, because I wanted to like do my own thing first and figure out the pack and what I wanted to do with it, and then watch other people's stuff and see like cool ideas that they'd come up with. So yeah, I've watched some other people's videos, so I took some inspiration from things that other people had done. Like here, this little like half wall thing that I did, not the thing with the lights, I came up with that on my own, so I'm pretty proud of that, but the little half wall thing in the middle of the fence with the hot tub, I saw Devin Bumpkin, I'm pretty sure, did that, and he, his was obviously like, not obviously, but his was like an actual vacation home. So this one's kind of nice because of the lot that it's on in Brindleton Bay. It's like facing the beach, which I think is like why it's a good spot for that. But like most of the time, it wouldn't be that useful to have this random little like half wall so you have a view out of the hot tub, because usually like if you're in a suburban neighborhood, you wouldn't have a view out of the hot tub. You'd probably just want more of a fence for privacy. But yeah, there was a nice little view of the beach, so I decided to do that because he did that in his build, and it was like a little well, it was obviously like a jungle view, but we've got the beach in Brindleton Bay, and I use those little toddler stuff pack lights that I can't get over. I mean, I don't use them that often, but I just love whenever I find a use for them or I feel like I'm building a house that suits them well. So yeah, I took advantage of those. And oh, by the way, this is just like a one bedroom little house, back to my usual, not tiny house, but like little small cottage type of thing. But this doesn't really look like a cottage because it's a little bit more Mediterranean, like Spanish inspired, than a usual cottage that I would build. But yeah, same type of size. It's just one bedroom. You could make it a second bedroom, maybe. Like, you could probably drag that other room, make it a little bit bigger, or just like shove a bassinet in there and call it a nursery. But it's kind of like a skill building room. But ooh, part of why I'm talking about the build kind of just generally right now is because I want to talk about the new My First Pet stuff pack thing that's coming out, because I want to hear what you guys think about it. I won't say never, but I really don't see myself ever being making it a habit to make those like reaction type videos. I don't know. I just don't have time to be reacting to things immediately enough to feel like people would want to watch my reactions over other people's reactions, if that makes sense. Like, I feel like by the time I would actually have the time to record the video, it would be like too late and everyone else would have already reacted to it. So it's like, I don't know. But I wanted to talk about it in this build voiceover because, you know, you can just enjoy me building this house. And if you are so over this stuff pack discussion, you can always just mute me and listen to something else, because I did that the other day. Not that I didn't want to listen to the person that I was watching, but I had an audiobook I needed to listen to for school. So I just muted their build and listened to my audiobook. Which it was fine. I actually listened to some of the voiceover later just to make sure, because I do, like, I enjoy listening to people's voiceovers, but sometimes like life happens and you just really need to do school. So that's what I did the other day. So yeah, just pro tip, if you're ever either not liking what someone has to say, but you want to watch their build, just find something else to listen to and continue on. And then you still get to enjoy the build, but you don't have to listen to whatever they're talking about that you don't want to hear about. So there's that. But yeah, this stuff pack, I don't know about it. First, my first reaction was I was like, I'm still so excited about Jungle Adventure. I can't even like fathom putting new content into my game. And I was kind of annoyed that, because I feel like almost obligated to buy all of the packs now because I do currently own all of them. But my original plan when I saw the trailer, or like just heard about this one, like the little teaser trailer, I was like, I'm not going to buy this right away. It's not worth it. I still haven't even fully explored Jungle Adventure. I want to do that before I buy a new pack. But then when the trailer came out, and especially when SimGuru Graham started answering questions on Twitter, I don't know if you guys keep up with that. Also, I don't even know if like you guys keep up with the Sims stuff on Twitter. I feel like if you're on Twitter and you're following Sims things, then you probably like know what's going on. But if you don't, then I don't know, maybe you don't know what's going on. Also, if like I said earlier, with my like changes to my schedule recently, I always like tweet when I decide to change things in my schedule. Like, if I'm not going to post a certain video that I would usually post that day, I'll always tweet about it. So if you guys don't follow me on Twitter, or even if you don't have a Twitter, but like maybe you're just like wondering if like why I didn't post a certain video on a certain day, and if I don't address it in the voiceover, then you can always check my Twitter, and I'll usually, if I don't give a reason, I'll at least mention that I'm not posting something on a certain day and I'm posting something else instead, if that makes sense. So yeah, just so you guys know about that. But anyway, back to the stuff pack. So my initial reaction was like, what the heck is this? We just got a pack and now they're randomly, like a week after the pack was released, they announced, not even, it was literally 6 days, they announced a new pack that was no one asked for, in my opinion, and most people had the reaction of it should have been included in Cats and Dogs. So I was kind of annoyed because I like to really experience all of the content, which sounds kind of lame, but, or maybe it doesn't, I don't know. But I really like to, especially because now that I do have all the packs, I'm very scared of like having wasted money and like not getting the full experience of each pack. But since I build, I feel like I do get a lot of use out of the majority of the packs. But also from a building perspective, especially when I saw the trailer, there were a few clutter items that I really liked, but there were also like the bulk of the furniture is really not my style at all, and I'll probably use it in kids' bedrooms, but other than that, I have no idea how I'm going to use most of the stuff that is coming in that pack. I think it will probably be one of my least favorites. Like, some people hate on Cool Kitchen stuff, but I use the clutter from Cool Kitchen stuff like all the time. So, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But the one thing that I am very excited about is the new little pet, the little like rodents. I think that they're really cute and I'm actually really excited for them. And I noticed that their little habitat thing had a bulletin board on it. And in some of the little clips in the trailer, there were postcards. And I was like, that's so weird that they would just add this postcard thing to the like hamster cage or rodent habitat. I don't know. I thought that was really weird. But then I saw on Twitter when SimGuru Grimm was like answering questions, that people were tweeting him, he said that there was like this little like rocket thing that like rocketed out of the habitat and part of the trailer. And he said that that's, I don't know if he said a hamster or like whatever animal, but he said that it was going on vacation and sometimes they send you postcards. So then I was like, oh, now it makes sense that there's this postcard thing. And I think that's really cool. That's like, I love that level of detail. And I think that the new pack, I am going to get it right away because of, I thought that that was cool, but not even that. It was more when I found out that there was a new death, I was like, okay, I'm getting this pack. Like, there's a new death. What the heck? I need to experience it. But yeah, don't expect any my first pet stuff builds from me. I probably won't be doing that. No my first pet stuff themed room builds. I didn't even do like a laundry room build. And I love laundry day. So yeah, if that tells you anything, then yeah, definitely won't be doing anything super like my first pet stuff themed. I probably will use like two of the items in the pack in any of my builds. So if you ever see that I'm using the pack in a build you want to download, rest assured, it's probably not that much and you can probably be fine without it. But anyway, this build is over. So I would really want to know what you guys think about this pack, especially for those of you that don't buy every pack and like, I have a feeling that a lot of people probably won't buy it. But if you have cats and dogs and you usually don't buy stuff packs, are you still going to buy this one? I don't know. I want to know. Let me know. I'm running out of time, but I hope you enjoyed this build and this completely random voiceover. But I got to get my thoughts out there, so that's good. And thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Bye!